Hey everybody, welcome back to the Side-by-Side Guys. Today we're going to be taking our first look at the Baja Designs lighting package that we're going to be installing on Ian's X3 RC. This lighting package consists of a 10-inch Onyx 6 Plus light bar that's going to be mounted to his shock towers, and it also includes a 30-inch RTL light for the rear for safe driving at night and in the dust. The Baja Designs Onyx 6 Plus light bar is comprised of 6 onboard LED chips, putting out over 9,000 lumen on low and over 12,000 lumen on high. This light bar puts out a ton of light at only 10 inches wide. So this is a perfect solution to go right on the shock tower of Ian's X3 and will put out just an insane amount of light. Now, that light is focused into a 6-degree spot pattern down the middle on the middle 4 chips. And then the lens on the outer 2 chips is a 42-degree wide pattern beam. So it doesn't actually throw the light up and down very far. It's still at 6 degrees of projection, but it actually spreads it out horizontally. So if you look at the lenses, you'll notice that they have vertical ripples in the lens, and that's because that light is being projected out and wide, not out and up. So very interesting design into this light bar. It's a very convenient package for anybody looking for a compact light bar to put out a ton of light. The Baja Designs Onyx 6 Plus light bar is made from aircraft grade aluminum. It has a hard coated polycarbonate front lens that is actually user swappable, and you can put custom lenses in there at any time you wish. So if you want to, you can buy it in one combination and then buy a lens for a different scenario. So if you're out doing normal trail riding and you want just a flood pattern, you can actually have that lens on the machine when you're out doing that. And then on the weekends, if you're racing, you can actually swap that lens out and put all just a forward focus spot to get you down the trail further. And so you'll never outrun this light, and you'll never be able to be stuck with one type of light throw. You can always customize it down the road as well. This 10-inch light bar is also IP69K rated, which means you can submerge it under 9 feet of water and never have any worry about ingress of water into your light bar. This light bar is also rated for pressure washing. So if you wanna permanently mount it to the front of your rig and clean your rig off after a muddy day on the trail, that's not gonna be a problem and not something you're gonna have to be concerned about with forcing that water through the front seals. This light bar is also IK10 rated, which means that it's gonna survive a slew of impacts from any angle on the light. So if you're constantly getting hit with roost from the vehicles racing in front of you, or if you're always concerned about brushing up against tree limbs, things like that at speed, this is not a worry. This light bar is gonna take it. As long as you have it positively affixed to your machine, it's not going to ever have a problem with durability. The Onyx 6 Plus light bar will consume about 5.7 amps and draw about 80 watts from your stator on the low setting. On the high setting, it's gonna pull about 108 watts at 8.4 amps. So this is a very powerful 10-inch light bar. This is not your eBay special light bar. This light bar is gonna put out over 12,000 lumen on high and pull 108 watts off your stator. So if you've already got a ton of accessories and you're pushing a big sound system, you know, this is when you start to think about what's the impact on your voltage. Are you gonna be drawing down your battery too far and impacting that? The Baja Design lights, they don't skimp out on the output, so they're gonna be pulling every amp that they can. Now, the Onyx series and all their modern light bars and lights do feature an over voltage protection, and they also feature a mechanism to where if your system starts to go below the stated voltage, it'll actually dim the lights down to a lower setting to reduce the draw on your battery. So this is very useful. If you've ever had a cheaper light bar that it doesn't feature this type of technology, what you'll notice is that as your battery starts to degrade because of all the different accessories or maybe just the demand that you're putting on this vehicle, you'll start to notice that the lights will start to flicker. And when they start doing that, it can really mess with your vision. It can really mess with your reaction times and become ultimately unsafe. So having this where it'll actually pull the amperage draw down to maintain a consistent lighting pattern is actually a safety feature for many drivers. So it's something to consider when you're looking at the investment of your money versus the reward of the quality of product you're gonna be getting. The Baja Designs team really has put a lot of effort and thought into their products. And this is just an example of how their industry experience has played out into their product design. It's a really great feature. All right, so let's talk a little bit about light color temperature. So many light bars that you receive from the cheaper brands or maybe eBay, Amazon, things like that, those lights will actually put out a very blue, a very cold color temperature light. And the reason for that is because those lights are cheaper to make. Those LED chips are actually in the production process cheaper to acquire. So many of those brands will go with that bright blue looking spotlight on their lights. But the Baja Designs actually have a 5000K rated color temperature on the lights, and they actually color match their chips. So every light that you get will have the same color temperature. And it's very important for a driver that has multiple lights on their vehicle, that is doing racing at night or are doing any kind of high contrast visibility things where they need to have their lighting kind of match the daylight that they're going in and out of. It's actually a very important, often overlooked feature on lighting is the color temperature. And so having a warmer light will be less fatiguing on your eyes. I actually have a coating on my glasses that reduce the blue light in my environment to help reduce the eye strain that I go through. So that color temperature is actually really important. And so if you're ever out of the dunes at night or on the trail with a bunch of buddies, look at the different colors that you see coming off their headlights, their light bars, their light pods. They're all gonna be a little bit different, and they're gonna all tend to be more to the blue side. The Baja Designs product with that 5000K rating, everything's gonna be a really comfortable, warm white look. It's not gonna be orange or yellow, but it's gonna be a very warm, natural color, and that's gonna be really important when you're going at high speeds down the trail. Now, the great thing about Baja Designs and their replaceable lenses is that they also have an amber option. So if you're gonna be in a dusty environment, you do have the option to replace your clear lens with an amber lens, or if you do buy one with an amber lens, you can buy the replacement clear lens to go over that. So another great feature by a company that has been forward thinking in their products, and they're really gonna be putting out a great flexible product on your machine if you choose to invest in that product. All right, so let's take a look at the RTL light bar from Baja Designs. This light bar is 30 inches wide, made from the same aircraft grade aluminum that the Onyx 6 Plus light bar is made of. The lenses on the actual light bar itself are not the typical cylindrical lenses that you see on most cheaper light bars, but it actually is an onboard chip. So that means that the PCB board inside the light has a flush mounted LED that then projects out of the rear of the light. The reason that that is important is because that light doesn't need to be projected in one direction. That light needs to be projected in all directions. And so the light is made up of five different clusters of LEDs, and these will be a red running light slash brake light, an amber indicator for running or flashing, and then the center cluster will be either a white cargo light or a blue or green racing flasher for slow moving vehicles into the different racing requirements. So the 30 inch light bar will be a very important piece of equipment if you are gonna be in a racing scenario or if you're gonna be in a dusty scenario with people following you. If you've ever been out on a trail and you've been in a group of multiple cars and those multiple cars have been in front of you, you'll know that when that dust gets kicked up in front of you, it's very hard to see. Those headlights, those spotlights, those light bars make it really hard on the eyes to distinguish the contrast between the trail, the cars, your vehicle, and maybe any animals that may have crossed out in your path. To make the complication even worse, is that the red brake lights don't typically pierce through the dirt very well, especially if you're illuminating the dirt from your side. So what we found is that a chase light bar, a rear facing light bar with flashers, really does penetrate the dust really well and gives you a really good indicator of where that car is. And if they're flashing, if they're flickering back and forth, that can give you a little bit of a misguided presentation of where they're at if they're braking. But if they're solid or in a flash pattern that is not too exaggerated, you can really tell how fast that car is going in comparison to you, better when you have the amber lights versus not having those lights. And so it can be critical in those situations when you're out on the trail late at night with a bunch of friends, but even more critical out on the race course when you're going desert racing or things like that, having a rear chase light makes a huge difference in indicating, you know, where you are if you're a slow moving vehicle, and then just distinguishing you in the dust when you're going through the silt and those different obstacles where you're really close behind guys at speed. So a crucial piece of equipment if you want to stay safe in the dust. So the Baja Designs RTL light that we're gonna be installing on Ian's car is a max draw of 60 watts at complete illumination. So if all your lights were running, the brakes were on, the amber lights were on, and the center cargo light was on, 60 watts is what your draw is going to be. So it's really not that bad if you're considering the fact that for the most part, half of those lights are going to be off at any given point in time. They're made from the same aircraft grade aluminum, has the same lifetime warranty, has the same IP69K waterproof rating, and it has the same impact rating. Something to note is that the RTL lights do have a different type of lens over them. Because there's no rear projector, there's not a flat surface, it's more of a curved surface. That is a hard-coated polycarbonate, but it's not gonna be the same thick, flat plastic as your light bars. And you will wanna take a little bit of care with bumping into it with different things. So if you're gonna have a cargo situation where you consistently are putting things in and out and banging things into it, you may choose to maybe push it back a little further or a little higher to get it out of the way. But being a domed shape, it should take the impacts that you throw at it. And the hard coating should alleviate any kind of really bad scratching that's gonna happen. But it's not gonna be the same aluminum bezel protected flat polycarbonate that the light bars have. The other nice thing about the RTL light series from Baja Designs is that you can get them in multiple configurations, again, with the blue or the green center cluster. Additionally, the wiring for the lights enable you to utilize a red running light, a red brake light, and the ambers as turn signals if you want. And the white light can even be configured, if you know how to wire your machine up, as a reverse light. So if your machine has the ability to trigger a reverse when you go into the reverse gear, you could wire that up and it can be a reverse light to indicate that you're going backwards. Again, the configuration possibilities with the Chase light are a huge deal when it comes to safety. And one of the biggest things that I recommend for guys that are doing a lot of dusty driving. So we're really excited to have these lights on Ian's X3 this season. With the amount of lumens these lights put out, it's really gonna be an incredible experience to see such a small package put out so much light. Ian really didn't wanna have a big bulky light bar on top of his car. And so this 10-inch light bar to go on his shock towers is gonna be a really interesting new perspective in driving for lighting the surrounding area. You know, we've thought about putting a lot of different light cubes or light bars or scene lighting, maybe mirror lighting, but this is the first step into the high quality lighting game for that vehicle. And we are going to be pairing that up with a pair of LP4s on the front grille. We don't have those today to look at, but we're gonna look at those in the near future. So look out for that video. Check out our YouTube channel at Side by Side Guys and subscribe to make sure that you see that video when it comes out. I'm really impressed with the Baja Designs build quality. It really speaks to the premium nature of the product. When you pay that much money for a product, you expect to be able to pick it up, feel the quality in the product. And with Baja Designs, you absolutely get that. The Baja Designs really does demand a premium though, and you have to be ready for that. We're talking over $420 for the 10-inch light bar, and you're talking over $400 for that rear chase light. So they are not cheap. But when you talk about the quality and the lifetime warranty and the customer service that's gonna come with a reputable brand like Baja Designs and the technology that goes into these products, you're really gonna be saving a ton of money in repair costs, replacement costs, and that peace of mind knowing that you're not gonna have to worry about that product or worry about the electrical in that product or worrying about it flickering when it doesn't get enough power, things like that. Can just save you so much time, so much headache, and really enable you to focus on the task at hand if you're a racer or if you're just trying to be safe on the trails, things like that. So really impressed with the product, really impressed with just the sheer specs that come at in such a small package. And we can't wait to really get out and test these products. We're gonna follow this up with some awesome video to demonstrate their light output. We've got a light meter, we're gonna check that out and figure out what the actual output of these lights is. And we're gonna do some cool night footage to make sure that you understand, you know, exactly how it looks and feels when you're driving with these lights. So if you'd like to follow us on our Baja Designs light journey, we're gonna be adding a video on the LP4s. We're gonna be doing a full install and wiring video. We're gonna be doing a full nighttime shoot with these lights to give you a firsthand perspective on what the light looks like, what the scene lighting looks like, what the driving experience looks like, and we're gonna do our best to actually translate what it looks and feels like at the point of using the light in the vehicle on the trail. So we're gonna do our best to actually give you an honest perspective, not just one that seems like it's bought. We're gonna be completely honest and transparent. And so if you wanna follow us, make sure to follow us on YouTube at youtube.com/sidebysideguys. You can also follow us on Facebook and Instagram to get updates and new perspectives on these products and install highlights. And we can't really wait to get out on the trail with these things. These really do look like the solution that if you can afford it, that you should be buying. So super stoked, super excited to install them, and hope that you can follow us for the journey. So until next time, guys, peace. Back in the cut like a scratch, never acting, I've never been. Shut up my words while you're holding your breath like an asthma attacking him. Why are you testing me? Can't be investing no time in this. Team so focused, we are balling a butter rim. I used to pull forward, addicted, that had my stomach all in a twist. I had to dish the cup, yeah. Now I got those water bottles.